Hello children, in today's class we are going to discuss about mirrors and reflections. So what do you mean by mirror, which is a flat piece of glass that reflects the light? Not only the light but even an object which is in front of the mirror, clear? And what is a reflection, which is the production of an image by a mirror? The image which is formed by a mirror is called as reflection. In case if you place any ball or else a pencil or an eraser in front of the mirror, you could see an image of it in the mirror, right? That is called as reflection, clear? And we all use mirrors at our home, right? So if you look into the mirror, what will you see? You will see your own face inside the mirror. And what you see is the reflection of your face in the mirror. And even if you see reflections of other objects that are in front of the mirror, like you can see some trees or buildings and even some objects that are in the water of a pond or a lake. So those are represented as reflections. The objects that are in front of the mirror, which is being reflected in the mirror, is called as reflections. Clear? I hope you understood this definitions. And let us look into two different activities so that you can understand about this concept more clear. See here, in this first activity, this activity can be done only at night or in a dark room. So what you have to do in this activity is just look at the picture. Ask one of your friend to hold a mirror in his or her hand and tell her to stand in one corner of the room. Similarly, ask another friend to hold a torch straight away to the mirror and ask another friend to stand in the other corner. So what you have to do is ask this friend to switch on the torch. So what will happen, the beam of light that comes out from the torch will direct towards the mirror. If you direct the torch towards the mirror, the beam of light will pass on to the mirror. So once the beam of light pass on to the mirror, what happens there, you can see a patch of light is formed. That is the reflection of the light. Yes, see here. So what they are doing here, if you direct the beam of torch light onto the mirror that your friend is holding, you will see a patch of light on the other side. So if you adjust the direction of the torch, what happens, the patch of light will fall on other friends standing in the room. So if you see here, if you adjust the torch direction of the torch on the mirror, what happens, this patch of light which is there on the mirror will fall on the friend who is standing near to opposite to the mirror. So this is how that concludes that a mirror reflects a beam of light. So based on this activity, what you understood, first of all, a mirror changes the direction of light that falls on it. Clear? Now let us look into another activity where you will understand more about reflection. So to do this activity, the things which you need are a large thermocol sheet and then a comb, a torch, a dark sheet of paper where you have to place in between the mirror and the comb, and then a glass, that is the mirror. So these are the things which are required to do this activity. So to do this activity, what you have to do here is you have to fix a comb on one side of a large thermocol sheet and fix a mirror on the other side. See here, comb is fixed on one side and the mirror is fixed on the other side. Like this, you have to fix the comb and the mirror on the thermocol sheet. And in between this, you have to fix a dark sheet of paper in between the comb and the mirror. Clear? You have to spread a dark colored sheet of paper between the mirror and the comb. After that, you can keep this thing in sunlight, or you can send a beam of light from a torch through the comb. See here, they are sending a beam of light from a torch. Through this comb, you have to pass the torch light. So if you pass the beam of light through this comb, what happens? The light will pass onto the straight line and it will fall on the mirror. And after that, you can see this kind of a shadow from the mirror, which is a reflection of this object. So what did you observe? You will get a pattern which is similar to the shown in the figure. And this activity gives you an idea that the light will travel and gets reflected from a mirror. So the light is traveling from a torch through the comb, which is traveling in a straight line, and it is getting reflected on the sheet of paper. Yes, so I hope you understood both the activities, that how a light travels through a mirror and it how the light is getting reflected. Clear? So we have come to the end of the lesson, and in this lesson we have gone through so many concepts. So let us look at a summary regarding this lesson. So just recall about all the points. See here, an opaque object. If you three different types of objects we have discussed related to the light concept. One is opaque, where it will not allow a light to pass through that object, and the other one is a transparent, where it will allow light to pass through them and you can see objects very clearly, and a translucent object, where it will allow the light to pass through it very partially, whereas you cannot see the objects very clearly. And if you look at shadows, shadows are formed when an opaque object comes between the rays of light. Yes, and what about a pinhole camera? It can be made with a simple materials which are available in your home itself, and you can even use it to image the sun and brightly lit objects. And similarly, mirror, which is the reflection, gives us the clear images, and images are very different from shadows, and light travels only in the straight line. I hope you understood this lesson, children. So let us see in the next class. Thank you.